better listen. This ain't nothing but some boss talk. 100,000 on my wrist. Fuck around, send a few thousand on your bitch. She get nasty on the dick. Nasty. Got me a classy old little chick. Don't get that bad. She fuck around and throw a bitch.
Check it, man. Check it, man. Check it, man. Hold up, man. Did you hear that, man?
I heard it, man.
It's your boy, ECEO, man.
Hey, I'm gonna have to bring you one. I'm gonna have to do a boss talk theme song myself, man.
Everybody coming through, man. Hold up, man. Hey, man. It's your boy, ECEO, man. I'm here with the lovely official, Miss Jamaica. And check it, man. What's going on?
Not my dad. Walk on.
Hey, man, we back, man, again. Mm-hmm. He goes down, man. We got our guy in here today, mm-hmm. man. He needs no introduction.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? My boy Trill is in the building. What's going on, man?
Go shit.
You here now.
Oh, yeah, I'm in
you
here.
You made it now.
I'm in here.
You home, nigga.
Let's sit at the throne like bosses and talk.
Say, man, we can't be like bosses when we are bosses. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Real talk.
Man, you from Longview.
From Longview, born and raised.
And just give us a little bit of background on who you are, you know, just so the people who don't know who you are, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. I'm the nigga that always been behind the scene, man. Always behind the bushes, around the corner, you know what I'm saying? Man, did music all my life. That's just everything about me, music, you know what I'm saying?
When you started out, you was with a couple of more people, right?
Yeah, yeah. I've been through several groups, man. Like, I'm a little bit older, so I've been through back in the dance boogie area. But before that, you know what I'm saying, with the Jeezy trap shit back in the day, all the way up to now, you know what I'm saying? I had just evolved through time, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Yeah. But yeah, I've been through a lot of groups, man, out of Longview, man. Longview Finest, a bunch of groups I done been in, man. Anybody that you can name out of Longview or some of East Texas, I done worked with them, you know what I'm saying? I done started out a lot of groups too. Started out a lot of people's careers.
Yeah, wow, that's dope, man. So what when you first got into this thing, you was producing, right?
Yeah.
Producing tracks?
Yeah, first, you know, I was starting in high school, you know, I was a drummer, percussionist or whatever in the band and stuff like that, and got in some trouble. They kicked me out or whatever.
Got kicked out, huh?
Yeah, so that, you always had the love for music?
Always. I just met my dad last year.
That's the first time meeting. Yeah.
So I always heard stories of him beatboxing and stuff from my mom and, you know, uncles and stuff like that.
So that's where you get it from, the musical?
Yeah. So I kind of built my life around it, I guess, from wanting to be like him.
How did you, so you just met him?
Just met him.
But you knew of him?
Did you ever know of him?
Yes. I seen him one time when I was 18. He came down.
Wow.
Or whatever. We officially got a DNA test a couple years ago.
So y'all really wasn't sure?
Yeah, he wasn't sure.
How was that conversation, man?
I was young. It really was him between.
No, I'm talking about when y'all 18, you just not meeting him. How was that conversation?
Yeah. He really didn't want to speak on it or whatever. He was like, you know, we were just talking. He'd be normal talk or whatever. I only met him. It was about like 10, 15 minutes and he left.
Okay.
He came down to Longview because he's from up here in Oak Cliff. And we kind of talked or whatever a little bit. But I was just too young. I was just happy to see him, you know what I'm saying, back. And when I was 18 and stuff like that.
But
how did it feel growing up without your father?
My mom asked me that all the time, but I guess I got so used to it, it seemed like it never affected me. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Subconsciously, I didn't, but
I see now when I see other people with their dads and how they went to college and their dad had them, you know, just kind of how
taught
I see you with your kids.
Right.
You know, teaching them little things that they should know, you know, bank accounts and you know, credit and stuff like that. I see that when I had to learn, but I learned from, you know what I'm saying, from street dudes. That's what I learned. I was around them type of people, you know what I'm saying? That's what I learned, different things, which kind of bad in a way, but it made me who I am, you know
wow.
what I'm saying?
Yeah. Wow.
So you didn't have a father figure in your life?
Not really. I had a stepdad, but me and him, we beefed all the time, you know?
Straight everything. Up.
Any siblings?
Yeah, I got a younger sister, Rachel. Yeah.
So you're the older brother?
Yeah, I'm the oldest out of all the grandchildren.
Okay.
You're kind of like Baby Boy in the movie Baby Boy.
Yeah.
Melvin, you didn't get along with the nigga.
Yeah, nah.
Nigga coming over there cooking breakfast and stuff.
Melvin wouldn't put his hands on me like that, though.
Oh, so this nigga here had the audacity.
Nah, he wasn't.
Okay, well, you know, okay, yeah, you wasn't trying to hear that.
I wasn't trying to hear it.
But I get it, though, but I think that movie touched a lot of people because they could relate,
yeah.
man. Because
yeah,
that really was the way it went down a lot of times in our African-American homes.
Real talk, right, you man. Know, this we really vital, man. I encourage our fathers to really be there in their life, you know what I'm saying, and really cultivate their kids, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We gotta have that. We gotta have more than it, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, going back to the music part, you know, when I got kicked out a band or whatever, they put me in a different band hall by myself, like in a detention thing, because they didn't want to change me to another class at that time. So I would write out beats. You know, I knew how to write music and stuff. I used to write out beats and stuff, had binder full of it or whatever. So when I finally graduated from school, I've learned about, you know, FL Studio or whatever, which is a beat making program. Mm-hmm. And whatever, and I just learned, I'm like a master at it now, you know what I'm saying? So
you're a big old sponge.
Yeah, for real. That's
for
that's,
music, actually.
Yes, yes, yes. Business side, all of them.
Do you have kids?
Yeah, I got one daughter, man, Kinsley. She too. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, she too young to figure out if she's into the music.
Oh
yet.
Yeah, she into the music. You see it already?
Already?
Yeah, she. I can show y'all a video of her singing my song, you know, after the, you know, after the whatever. But right. Yeah, she loved the music.
Business side also.
Oh, look, yeah.
That ain't gonna slide. That ain't gonna slide by
you
me.
Gotta
like,
have, you gotta
I'm a
have
real
businessman.
Business, you gonna business all
the business.
Okay,
so gotta,
okay.
You know.
Well, let's talk about it then, okay. Nigga. Yeah. Nigga, jump up on this show talking about business,
it's
man.
90%.
So you on the right show today.
I know it. I
now
know
let's
it.
Talk about it. What kind of business?
Well, I own a business. You know, I own a appliance repair store, and I also sell used appliances. So,
okay, are y'all a sole proprietorship or corporation?
Nah, I'm sole proprietorship.
Let go, nigga. Yeah. But how did it go down? Did you get your CO? Did you go in there bootlegging?
Nah, I ain't going to bootlegging shit.
Yeah,
it really passed down from my grandfather, whatever. You know,
okay.
So I took over the family business and shit. Like,
all right.
You know
so did he instill anything in you about the business before he passed away? Or is he still alive?
Yeah, he still is.
Okay, good. Shout out to your
he still be up there fiddling around, getting on my nerves and stuff. Anyway,
but I like that. I like that's a passed down business. So that's your mom's dad.
My mom's dad.
That's dope, right there.
Yeah. But that's what I'm currently doing right now. You know, that's how I fund my music and stuff.
That's another thing I wanted to talk about these views and how niggas faking these views. Let me finish.
Go ahead.
These niggas is faking these views. God, dog, I ain't never seen nothing like it.
Yes.
But then they acting like they getting paid from the music. Now, I have exposed this. Shout out to Al D for calling me, checking me up on it. That, you know, it is something else that we have to try to understand how to turn our music into an ROI so we can gain, you know, momentum and putting money back into our people.
Real talk.
So, what do you think? How do you think we get there? And how do you deal with the fact of putting money into something that you're not seeing that return in? Now, these are some good questions.
Yeah, that's the story. That's pretty much the story of East Texas. You know, I done seen so many groups come and go and get discouraged, putting money into something. But I just really still think that it's something at the end of that pot, at the end of that rainbow. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to have to invest. And I have seen things or whatever where we get close, but, you know, sometimes it just don't go all the way through. And we get close.
What do you mean?
I'm talking about getting close to being to that stature of making your own money back
what
off of your
music.
What
the hell is close, Trilli?
Well, you know.
I want to know what close is.
Okay, close is like, okay, we don't have record labels that, like in New York, where we can just walk down the street and go and see. So when you get recognition from a label and stuff and they want to fly you out, or, you know, somebody reach out and say, man, I like your music, come meet me, or whatever. You know, I done started being with other artists that have done it. So that's kind of a recognition that I feel like that a lot of artists would never, ever see in their life, or whatever, doing this and stuff like that. So that's kind of, I'm saying, close to getting it. But we have artists like Cinco P, Young Pooter, if y'all look him up, you know what I'm saying? They don't actually.
I don't have to
number.
Look up Cico P.
Right.
He been here.
He been doing
this
it.
This is the first interview he got.
Right here.
Then he went to Genius after he left here.
Exactly.
So all I'm trying to say is, let's go back to why this is not happening. Now, you was down there. Here we go.
Yeah, I've
I'm
been
going
in the
back
trenches.
Now. So you've seen, how long you say you've been in music?
I've been in
Let
music.
Let me get him. Let me get him.
10, 15 years.
10, 15 years. You've been producing music for 10, 15 years.
Yeah.
Back then the radio was prevalent, right?
Right.
How many songs have you had played that you produced on the radio station locally in those areas? I'm talking about the stations in Texarkana.
I had a lot of artists because over time.
That's why I'm asking. I want to know.
But
how many?
Just because 15, 20.
I done heard.
But no, just because you spin it one time don't mean it's gonna be heard.
Well, they can't really just spin it all the time, but at least you got spent once.
Well, I feel like you got your own mix show. Okay. So I feel like, but back in the day, they used to have a deal called Homegrown where they used to get local artists, you send your music in. And
who was doing that?
First started out with DJ Black from the Blaze.
I heard about him.
Yeah, DJ Black started the first back in the day and shit. So you
is
know,
he still there or no?
He's still there. He's okay. A program director now.
Okay.
But like kind of earlier I heard in the other interviews, like it's kind of corporation when it comes to radio. You really have to go talk to the big suits to really get on the full rotation, and it costs money. But I feel like on the DJ's mix show, you can throw a little bit of your East Texas artist inside of there, your mix. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't, I just don't hear it on the radio a lot. And it needs to be more of that. It needs to be a conversation. And we really need to sit down with these DJs to make that happen.
How do they do it in Dallas, but they can't do it? They radio station big up here?
It'd be the same excuse when we ask. Like, you ask DJ Juice or whatever, and we don't have no control over it or whatever and stuff. But you will hear their artists on there or whatever, which is no. And I love, you know what I'm saying? I heard Smitty on there, you know, a lot. And that was real good. I was happy about that, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like it's other artists, too, than these two, because it's going to shine light on the local scene of people and fans around here that help you get motivated to want to go and do more things outside of East Texas.
So you heard Smitty on there. Did you hear Cinco P on there? You had over 7 million views on that song.
I ain't heard Cinco P.
You had over 7 million views on that. Yeah. I said 7 million.
7 million, mm-hmm. Yeah.
7
yeah.
million. Go look it up on YouTube.
Trust me.
And I'm going to be honest with you. I was looking at it trying to see how it spent that way. Yeah. I mean, the comments are legit. Everything seemed like, hitting on point.
To me, be honest and not to throw shade, if they working with them, I feel like they be on the radio more.
Working with who?
Like the DJs that's a part of the Blaze radio station.
If they working with them,
how? If they working with them,
how?
Like,
if they're their artists?
DJ, artists. Because, like, I used to work, if you know Camp Nowhere.
He worked, who was his
Camp brother? Nowhere, it's like my little brother, man. And, like, we came out with a song called Bloody Mary.
Okay.
And he got that song played a lot.
How?
Because DJ Juice was one of our kind of DJs, and we took him on the road.
Took him on the road with you.
Yeah, yeah.
So now you're telling me, so let me back up. So now you're telling me that DJ Juice does have the power to play the songs he want to play.
Yeah, I feel like on a mix show they do.
And you've seen him play what was influenced at the time around him.
Yes.
And he is trying, right?
He's trying. Like, he talk about it all the time and what up to artists. He done had a conversation with us. Like,
well,
everybody,
I'm going to tell you, boy, there's some noses turning up behind you. Like, that nigga ain't trying hard enough.
I feel like it ain't. Sometimes they get stuck in their ways, I feel like. That's what it is to me. Like,
I'm going
to
get really him back on the show.
Yeah,
He's going to come back on. Yeah, we're going to have that conversation, because I'm going to be honest with you, it has to be spoken on.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I keep hearing it, so it got to be, it's something, right, babe?
But mm-hmm. It's just two sides to everything, man.
So I want to hear his side. I'm going to get him on. I'm going to talk to him when I go down to y'all's show, and I'm going to ask him about coming on the show.
But my inspiration or whatever advice I tell the artists around here, like I tell our own artists, really, radio is starting to be like a dinosaur. You know what I'm saying?
It is, but it isn't. Local people around there, it motivates and encourages the community still. I don't think radio goes away.
It don't go away.
No, I think there's influencers in there that deal with the music industry and everything. Yeah. So I can't just say goes away.
I remember a time back in the day, if you had your song on the radio, you was the shit.
But like, now it don't really matter.
We just heard this on radio.
What about TV? It don't matter that much no more.
It really don't seem like that, you know, since YouTube and technology is out now. You on TikTok now, you doing something.
That's God. Right. You know, God will change the narrative.
He will.
People can hold you back so long, and then God say, you know what?
Let me open another door.
I'll open another door. Mm-hmm. Y'all prayers have been heard. YouTube is the answer to y'all prayers. What's the other one? Vivo.
Mm-hmm.
What's the other one, baby? Patreon? Is that it?
I don't remember.
Yeah, it's a bunch of them. Y'all prayers have been answered. You can play it wherever you want to play it. Put your budget behind your own self, your brand, and let's work. You know what I mean? And then you can't say you can't learn, because you can get on YouTube and ask any kind of question you want to and just take it there.
And take it there.
And then a lot of times, the artists are not working hard enough either.
Yeah,
There's not a lot of body of work out there. We hear a lot of people get one or two songs and they think they own it. It takes consistency. One thing that Jay-Z said to Kanye when they made that Through the Wire, he said, that's a good album, but can you keep doing it?
Right. That's one thing that they dropping the ball in East Texas. There's several factors or whatever, but consistency. Like, you have to keep dropping. You got to keep posting on your page. You can't post every 2 weeks. You can't drop a song every 5 months, 6 months. You know what I'm saying? You got to really be in their face or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's like campaigning. When you're trying to become president, you go to city, you showing up, you showing people, you know, that you are worthy of your craft, you know, and everything. But if you just barely doing it, they're not going to, you know, it's called branding. Like, they're not going to remember you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, what are you doing to get yourself in a situation where you can be heard? What is Trilli doing?
Right now, I'm in the recording process. I'm going to be honest. I just started being an artist this year. You know, for years and years and years, people would tell me, man, you need to become an artist. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need to start getting behind that mic, because I help write songs to a lot of artists that I work with and other artists that are, you know, or whatever and stuff like that. I'm like, well, you need to try it yourself. And I finally got the courage over after all these years, and it turned out beautiful to me. You know, so I'm in love with it now. So I'm in the recording process now.
I seen you in one of your videos. You act like you know what you're doing.
Oh, yeah. Trust me. I'm going to go. You ask anybody out there, they know. They like, know.
You've seen enough people do it.
Yeah. Yeah. You're right. So that's kind of how, you know, learning how to, you know, knowing what I need to do, you know.
Let me check this song out. I hope it's everything you talking.
Oh, yes.
Because right. If it ain't, it's going to be weird. It's going to be real weird if all you don't right. jump.
Come on.
That thing got to jump, man.
Mama Scott love this song.
She do?
Yeah.
Well, heck, we'll love it too if I turn my Bluetooth on.
How did you meet Mama Scott?
Man, okay. So I try to do a lot of things. After me doing music, I had like a voice in the streets or whatever of doing positive things, and I try to do positive things for the, you know, because we don't have any platforms down there for artists to do their thing. So I came up with a group. We got a couple of other people and stuff like that, and it was called the Umbrella Group, where we would try to put money in the pot to open up, you know, rent out venues for people to, artists to come in and do songs and stuff like that to get more awareness. And Mama Scott seen us on live or whatever, and she was like, she was mad about one of the dudes said something. So she hit me up, she's like, who is this dude, man? He just repeated something I said on live. I think he copying off me. I said, nah, ma'am, I don't think it's like that or whatever. And I started telling a little bit about myself.
Oh, she want a rough house.
Yeah, she was rough houses, man.
Oh, she always been it out.
Yeah, she always been here, man.
I can't wait to get her back on the show. I am the one.
Right.
I likes to get down like that. Right, yeah, right. Yeah, Mama Scott say, yeah. I said that the nigga bit my style.
Yeah, that's what she said. That's what she said. So I went to her house and met her. I met her sons and everything. And I was like, y'all pretty dope. And whatever. And back in the day, everybody knew me as Mastermind or whatever.
Ooh, that's producer. A heavy name.
Yeah, yeah. I lived up to it, I feel like. And one of her sons was talking about a dude like Mastermind. Like, man, I knew this dude Mastermind back in the day. He used to make beats and stuff like that. And I looked at my arm. I said, that's me right here. And they were like, they damn died or whatever. But
you've been putting that work in. That's God, man.
I have. I was on YouTube a long time ago, back in 2007.
Okay, you know how many subscribers you got then, nigga?
Oh, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You didn't count a lot. Them white boys. I only got about
500, man.
Yeah, that's because you ain't working up towards the
subscription. I wasn't working at first. I was putting all my.
Should be rich now.
I was putting all my gifts into other people, I feel like. Yeah. You know, a lot of people let me down, you know what I'm saying?
You know, that's the first thing I check niggas up on is the fact that,
you got
that part is your business now, Mono. Yeah, that's one of your most important essential elements is your platforms, your social media platforms, and TikTok. And all that different stuff, Facebook, Instagram, Likey, huh?
Right.
So but everything happens for a reason. So sometimes you had to go through all of that because where God intended for you to be, he wasn't ready for you to be yet.
Right.
You had to learn certain things first.
Exactly. You're right. Right. And I'm happy to be at this point right now. You know what I'm saying? But Mama Scott, like I owe her a lot because East Texas was dry bones until that woman got on the scene. I'm telling you. When we became and created that Fast Bash, that was the first melting pot in years where, you know, all artists had got together and seen themselves on a high statue, you know what I'm saying?
I like it.
Producers started working with producers, artists started collabing. They learned about Twan Visuals. Twan Visuals, to tell you, that's when he first got his start. We introduced him out there, whatever. Matter of fact, I got him to shoot a video at Fast Bash during the performance of Cam Nowhere. Or whatever and stuff like that. A lot of people like they were liking him, so he kind of grew out for that also. But yeah, man, Mama Scott is the GOAT. She the one turned this whole deal around. I owe everything to her. Wow. She woke me up because I was discouraged at that point. You know, I've been doing this for so long, and everybody I helped or whatever really turned their back on me after they, you know, or they gave up or whatever, but I still had more with me, you know what I'm saying?
Out of the time that you've known her, what is the one lesson that she's given you that has stuck with you ever since?
Man, she got so much love in her, no hate. That's one thing that I have. Like, I see people do her wrong and she'll still turn around and love them. And at the end of the situation, they'll turn back and love her more, you know what I'm saying? Like, putting gifts in people and inspiring people. When she go live, she was just going live a while ago. When you get through watching her lives, you're going to be inspired. You're going to want to go do something or whatever. So she is really a big voice of East Texas to me, you know what I'm saying? But love, spreading love, that's what I see, you know what I'm saying? Because she could have stopped it promoting her sons or her team, but no. Like, she just created Fast Bags, you know. That's where a lot of people, man, you just see them kids up there, so how happy they been. They never have been in a crowd that big to show their talent. And, like, that's just something that you can't, that's more than money, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, she has a great energy. The things that I've seen in her since I met her, I just recently met her, and I like what I see.
Me too.
Until she showed me flaw, I'll never call her, you know. Me too. I would never say
she ain't showed me yet. I've been by her side 3 years.
That's dope.
Mm-hmm. And even then, you know, we all have flaws. So
no, not me.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Even
no.
When a person shows their flaw.
You don't got no flaw
in
you.
No flaw in me, man. I don't know what she talking about.
Okay, listen, man. So, okay,
I'm not
Jesus.
Trying to hear that.
I bet she know all Jesus. Your flaws. How many years y'all been together?
We've been together a long time, but let me just be real with you. First of all, you said right, Jesus, when you said that, because I'm covered in the blood. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So how could you be flawless when the Bible says, be ye perfect as he is perfect?
Nah, you ain't as perfect as Jesus, 5 and 48 of Matthew.
Yeah, but he says to be perfect.
Yeah,
So if you believe in him,
right?
Then you are perfect.
You are perfect.
I'm gonna be honest, but at the end of the day, if you start looking at all the things that you fail in, you'll never accomplish anything. What I'm telling you is, man, you gotta focus on the prize. And every time you have a fault, you should press forward. You should never look back.
No.
Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all too busy looking at the issue.
You can't.
Instead of being the solution. Yeah, man. I'm following the light. I can't see nothing else. I'm trying to get there.
All right, come on, preacher.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you call it what you want. I'm trying to get there. You know what I'm saying? So, until we get there, you know, we got to be covered by him.
We got to,
so,
man.
You know, but
gotta have God.
I think you say you got a kid?
Yeah, I got a kid. Kinsley, man, it's my baby. She's 2 years old, and she's just like me.
Yeah. You like, say y'all sing together?
Oh, yeah. We be singing
rap
together.
Rap together?
Oh, yeah. Well, I be writing songs in the truck. I be playing beats. She be back there screaming. She don't know what she's saying, but she be back
Man,
there screaming.
Man, let me tell you something. KLC told a story about his daughter. KLC with Beats by the Pound when he was on here. And he said that when they did Body Body, the song. You remember Body Body?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He said that. I said, well, how did you come up with that beat? And I thought he was going to say something extraordinary.
Right.
But he did, in a sense. He said he went upstairs, and when he came back down, his daughter had hit the beat machine. And when she hit the beat machine, that's how you get them beats that you're hearing from Body Body.
Dang, that's crazy.
Just her hitting the beat machine because he told her don't be messing with it.
Right,
remember
right,
that?
Right.
And
she
said,
playing the drums.
Yeah, he had been messing with it, and she, and he kept
God,
it.
God dang, that's dope, God. Right? That ain't no God, man.
It became a hit, a massive hit, right?
Right,
and it was recording, and then he sent her out of the room, and then when he went back to start his work, and he was listening to it, he heard it, he was like, that's it right there.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Man, you just never know, man, what God.
I know you can relate because producing music.
I feel like God gave me everything to say, you know, when I write these songs and stuff like that. I go back and listen to myself. How the hell I come up with that punchline, you know, all that, you know, but
let's see what you got, man. You know, hopefully God help you with this one. You know what I'm saying? Is that it?
That's a beat. That's one of my
beats.
That's
a beat. Let's check it out. All is you.
Yeah.
Say, look out, Trilli.
Yeah, that's some light work. Straight up, straight up.
I like that, man. Yeah, yeah. Hey, I'm bringing a shout out to 88 and DJ Ice and Trilli and Sergeant J, all the producers that have been coming on the show. My boy Mad Max. I'm finna put y'all on the panel together. Everybody bringing their beat. One, I'm gonna do it two at a time, but y'all can't know each other. I wanna come and get these conversations. I'm doing that on Boss Talk. That's
like
my thing.
Like
I'm the only one. Nigga, I got plans, nigga. I can keep going, you know what I'm saying? But it's gonna be something to where I'm gonna match up to two guys and we're just gonna talk about the way that the way the beats are being processed.
Yeah.
We got something else going on over here. I don't know what these other folks doing.
I don't know what they doing, man. They slipping, man.
But I like that beat, man. And,
appreciate it.
I mean, I wish you'd have sent me more. Well, I'd have went there. I get excited. See, nobody don't do it like Boss Talk 101.
They don't, man.
I'm telling you right now. It's a hell of an interview when you start watching. Let me get... So the other one that you sent me... That's Chelsea Henderson sent something. Hell, Chelsea, and ain't her interview over?
I told her to send it for me.
Is that you? Okay, that's you?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get to it then. I thought she was trying to get back on the show. She gonna sneak back in and punch her little way back in.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it right there.
Yeah.
That sound like a, like it got an old school feel to it. That back, that
Bop on that bitch, no TikTok. Slide through the city like a sheriff. So big Glock, nigga so lame.
Okay.
I never ever switch by queen on the toe. I never ever
flip
flop. Nothing in material. What? Never reach tip top. Don't call me no rapper. This ain't no damn hip hop. Let this bitch got the dick in the lip lock. Where's my time? Just look at the wish wise. I never seen before.
Seen the
people smiling in your face despite you on the low. Remember them nights we didn't have the slightest place to go.
Place
don't
to
need
go.
No rest because it's clear to see we up the score. Ain't been broke in a minute. FAST ENT independent, like the 99, no limit. I make you laugh when you with me. Know that the drip is terrific. But please don't try nothing with me. Toting that fire, I be tripping. We slide tonight.
Okay, that's your beat, nigga. I see how you feel, man. Like that, nigga. I like that, man. Yeah,
appreciate it.
Say, man,
it,
I got it. Now I play when I want to, nigga. That's how I be getting y'all to send me y'all music, nigga. Then I just go home and vibe out, nigga.
Right,
free, nigga. I'm robbing you, nigga. Y'all don't even realize. Yeah, nigga, keep sending them songs. I'm going to play them all night at the house.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't going to lie to you. I'll be so busy. I don't get to listen to nothing.
For real, man. For real.
But I like that, man. You know,
hell,
what's the name? I get songs so quick. My partner Dallas P just did one with Erica Banks. He sent it right to him. It's like I got to hear that whole just to see. Yeah, they want me. I got one. Sit, what you think? You know,
man, a lot of
that's love,
send me
man.
A lot of people send me their word. Like,
they know you
man,
got
to
hear.
What you're talking about. Yeah.
I'm
like, man.
And I ain't trying to tell nigga what he want to hear either. I'm gonna tell you nigga the truth. You know that song right there, man, had a good feel to it.
I
mean, you know, to be honest with you, I can't say that it's the best I ever heard.
Yeah.
I gotta be real with you.
Oh yeah.
You gotta do stuff on a whole nother level with all the oversaturated stuff we're dealing with in the market.
Yeah. You gotta.
So
be
even
different.
If you got a song, you gotta have five songs.
Yeah.
Even if you've got a song, not only do you have to have five songs, but then you gotta have five visuals to go with the song.
Exactly.
You gotta
got
go
to.
Over the top when it comes to
you
dealing with what we're dealing with today.
Man,
and most people don't understand, but it's content over create.
You're
meaning
right.
At the end of the day, quit thinking about how I'm gonna be romantic with it and get it just right.
Wow.
No, nigga.
Put out
stuff
whatever you got.
Because
put
at
it
the
out.
End of the day, nigga will forget about you
quick
right now.
I'm telling you.
If your music ain't coming, you gotta have something quarterly.
The way they make this technology is, man, is people gonna slip you up. Like you gotta come with it because it's so easy to make a record. You can do it at your own home. You can put it uploaded at your own home. You don't really need all that what you had to have back in the day, all them engineers and marketing people and stuff. You can do it all yourself.
Definitely.
So don't slip. Go on, get the shit out. If you holding on music, go on, put it out. You know
top
what I'm saying?
Top three artists of all time.
Dead or alive. Any genre.
Yeah, you knew it. You done heard this 5-6 times now. About 3 times.
I fuck with Boosie, man.
Boosie, that's your number one?
Nah,
shout out
number.
Boosie, man.
I love Sam Cooke. I don't know if y'all
which
know
one?
Him.
What the hell you mean? Sam Cooke.
Sam Cooke, that's
everybody
my name.
Everybody knows Sam.
Are you going to say you don't know if we know
some people,
Sam
a lot of
Cooke.
People don't know him, man. That's that old school, you know what I'm saying?
I'm going to be honest with you. You ain't old enough to be telling me about what old school you is, to be honest with you. Don't come over here talking about old school. You hear that name?
Young nigga, man, still so wet behind the ears when you take them earphones off, nigga. Yeah, you had not old school.
Number three.
Man, it's so many, dog. I can't really just put it in a number three in the spot, but I'm fucking with Kodak right now, man.
Kodak?
I am.
That nigga bad, too.
It is summer.
That's the first Kodak.
No, that nigga bad. It might it's be, like, but I've been knowing. I've been waiting.
It's not
on
even
it.
His music, just him as a person.
His whole like, brand. Like that's what you're saying. I love everything I love, that he
me
do.
Me too.
You know, it's a way that they make that happen, too.
Yeah.
It ain't just it happening that way. Once you've been doing it long as Kodak's been doing it, you know how to initiate what's going on with your brand.
Like
and people don't realize that, and that's a craft within itself.
Right. He can go to jail and come
Gucci
right back
Gucci the
out.
Same way.
Gucci man good
Gucci
too.
Man the same way. Yep. Gucci know exactly what he's doing with 1017 right now.
Oh, yeah, man.
He and I can tell you, when he first did it, he didn't give no change out of nothing, mm-mm. and he still was influenced the whole music. Yeah, the industry was influenced by him early
his
on.
His sound and everything, you know what I'm saying?
Look, I mean, shout out to Tip and them. They did their thing, but
they did their trap music.
Yeah, but it ain't really just.
It didn't have that style like when him and what's that producer Zay Tobin when they came out with their duo, like that changed the whole sound of Atlanta music too. Like
shout out to Zay Tobin, that nigga man. Be hitting me back in my DM. Nigga.
Oh, you do?
One of the realest niggas out here. Yeah, the nigga posted me on his page too. Mm. Shout out to that nigga. Yeah, he posted Boss Talk on his page, and that's what I'm talking about. You know, a lot of people be talking, man.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you know, when you posting my stuff on your page and liking the stuff we doing and talking back in the DM because there's a lot of fake
it's
people out there, bro.
A lot of fake people out there,
man. A lot of times I did things and actually, you know, when I was doing it didn't seem like it was even, you know, a hidden right. You can go ahead. And but at the end of the day, he showed me
he
love.
He showed
me that people out there that do got a million views will holler at you.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And you don't see that a lot.
Exactly.
So shout out to Zay Tobin, man. I'm gonna tag him in this too, cause I know he gonna look at it.
Oh yeah.
You know, most
yeah.
niggas ain't even looking at it. They acting like they too good cause they got a few followers and all that, and they ain't got beside they self. Nigga, y'all see the mics. I ain't gonna get arrogant on you. Y'all see the cameras. Y'all see the angles. Yeah, let me talk my talk right quick. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, you gonna let them see it.
Yeah,
but we gonna shine. Yeah,
we gonna let them see it.
But
man,
I know, you know,
to.
The thing I can say is I'm not being arrogant. I'm saying we putting a lot into making sure we show tough artists out of the Dallas, East Texas, Arklay, Texas area,
right.
Dallas, Fort Worth.
Right.
Shout out to you know, Supreme and K Breezy for coming through the other day.
Oh yeah,
everybody that been on the show, man. The lineup is crazy. You know what I'm saying?
I'm praying you can continue to grow.
What you talking about, man? Hey, no, God already said it.
He's already
you here, ain't you?
Yeah.
This stuff ain't rented. Hell, this stuff paid for. And insurance is on it. You good. Hell, get comfortable over there.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to get comfortable. I'm going to get comfortable for sure. So, they don't be my last time.
You with them? Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Okay, man. You know, the thing, I definitely want to recognize the fact that the way you guys are moving as a unit, the way you guys are putting up your money, I know your bosses, you belong on Boss Talk.
Because
the conversations we done had, we know the real bosses.
Boss,
niggas bosses is who put up money.
Money,
You know, if you want to be a boss or your brand, put some money
you
up.
You got to.
You can't, you know what I'm saying?
Can't be being cheap on nothing.
And I see you guys, bossing up.
Yeah, we're not missing no steps, man. We really putting
it out. Traveling.
Yes, traveling everywhere. We just came back from Miami, you know what I'm saying?
Was in Atlanta before.
Been in Atlanta
about 4 or 5 times
this
year. I seen you.
Oh, yeah. So we've been
doing all that. It takes all of that.
It takes all of it, man. And it get better and better and better in time.
Yeah, man. That's what I'm talking about, man. So, so if you could talk to the younger you.
Yeah.
When you first was getting duped by all them people that you got duped by, nigga, when they was taking your beats and all kind of stuff, wasn't paying you, wasn't giving you recognition, you was about, 16, 17?
16, 17.
What would you say to that guy to try to help him get through those curves?
I would tell myself to go and get behind that mic, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, early on.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Like, I kind of came up with a little alias, it's Trill Kanye, because I kind of mind myself as Kanye West a little bit because he made his own beats at first and then he started spitting. You know what I'm saying? So that kind of made me kind of want to get into that or whatever. I started calling myself Trill Kanye. You know what I'm saying?
Already, man. That's dope.
Heck yeah, man. It's a journey, though.
Tell us how, because I know we got to get you out here because you got a shoot to get to.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell us how we can get a hold of you, man. Look at that camera right there.
You can get at me at say_lookout_trilli on IG, Facebook, same thing. Say Look Out Trilli everywhere, YouTube, Twitter, TikTok, all of that, man. Check me out. Check me out for that's real, dope, man.
So, you know, I hope you enjoyed the show much as I did.
Oh, yeah, I did.
You know, you guys are coming through, man. We're blessing you, man. We're saying, know, we're looking out.
Oh, yeah.
Period.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it.
No ifs, ands, or buts about
yeah,
it, man.
Yeah, man. You got to.
Hold up, man. You got. We got one, man. Sometimes you got to front a nigga out. Oh, nigga, yeah. You know I be recording up here on Fridays and stuff, man. You know to just come up here. Now, why the hell you calling me in the middle of my show? Well, nigga, come up here and don't call me. You know not to call me. I got a guy here worth $1 million right now. Yeah, I don't even want to talk about it. Now you're fanning out. I got to go, man. That's how we do. We might do anything on here. I ain't going to lie to y'all. You know what I'm saying? Because we free.
That, man. It's
you
real,
know what I'm
man.
Talking about? We free.
This real TV.
Yeah. We're going to do it the way it's supposed to be done. We ain't cutting none of this out either.
Man, I can't wait till y'all come to Fab Bad, though, man.
Say, man, as long as y'all give me a room.
I got
where
your
I can
room.
Set my setup up like this. Because this
Scott
is
got your
all
room.
That's going to be there.
Yeah.
So I got to be able to talk to people and they got to come over and sit and talk. It got to be boss talk. It got to be boss talk level.
If y'all artists, if y'all not even performing at the Fab Bass, come in and get with these media people, man, because that's going to be another level of getting y'all more exposure, especially Boss Talk 101. You got to come.
For sure.
Get that interview, exclusive interview with them.
It's going to cost you some money, though. Yeah. It's going to cost you something because this ain't, I really don't charge nobody. I'm looking at the talent. Yeah. I ain't charging not one person. Mm. I don't do none of that. All I do is basically pick the talent I want to deal with.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, I feel like, you know, when it's time, it's time. But now, I just want to bless people.
Right.
I'm blessed.
Gotcha.
You see where you at.
Yeah.
I ain't hurting.
Right.
So, are we hearing, babe?
No, man.
You checked the camera?
I don't look like y'all hurt.
Already. You know what I'm talking about, man?
Y'all don't look like y'all hurt, man. Yeah.
But no, man, at the end of the day, man, we thank you for coming on.
Right, I appreciate
it. Say truly, we love you, brother.
Appreciate it. We love
and at
y'all
the end
too,
of the day, man, babe, you know, we going to pull up on them at Fast Bass.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah.
Shout out my team, Fast Entertainment, man. Mama Scott, DJ K, AJ1K, The Journey, Franchise, Chi Hendy, you know what I'm saying? Everybody else in our corner and everything. Shout out my big bro, Bigger Bag Tim. All y'all, man, like whole East Texas, man.
Already, man. Say, man, hey, man, it's been another great segment of Boss Talk 101.
And we out.